Later today, this afternoon, the president will announce what many members have called his budget do-over. As one of our colleagues have pointed out, it is quite interesting that this weekend, it was not previewed by the Secretary of Treasury, it was not previewed by the Director of OMB, instead it was previewed by his campaign manager. So many of us approach this speech with perhaps high hopes and low expectations. We have an open mind. If the president will do something to help put us on the path to prosperity, we would be most appreciative. But this week, House Republicans will vote on the path to prosperity budget, which will ensure that we create jobs, that will ensure that we give the confidence job creators need, that we cut spending to make sure that our children and our grandchildren retain the American dream, and take us away from the path to decline.
The American people know that we can't continue to spend money that we don't have. I think the American people also understand that this hurts our economy and hurts job creation in our country. That's why Paul Ryan came forward as chairman of our budget committee to bring a budget and a path to prosperity that will not only balance the budget, but will pay off our debt. It's time that America develop a plan to save the next generation. And I believe that the budget we will consider this week, in fact, does that. You're also aware I have been pushing the president for months to engage in this discussion about our long-term fiscal mess. I'm glad that he's finally decided to engage in it. But there's been a lot of discussion about the need to raise taxes. And I'll just say this. We can't tax the very people that we expect to reinvest in our economy and to create jobs. Washington has a spending problem, not a revenue problem.
We are shortly going to go over to the White House for the pre-meeting before the president gives his highly anticipated speech as what we are calling the budget do-over speech. Now let's remember that this speech is coming a full 2 months after the president's original budget proposal and speech to the nation of the State of the Union. You know, this is vintage Obama. He's been standing on the sidelines expecting the rest of us to make the tough decisions to lead this country. We have and are this week putting on the floor the Ryan budget proposal that actually lays out specifics as to how we expect to deal with the debt problem in this country. And we do so by ensuring that we bring down spending, that we reform the entitlement program so we get rid of the unfunded obligations over time to retire the debt. I'm hopeful we hear specifics, but I hope we don't have a redo and a do-over of the tax agreement that we came to together last December. Again, this was an issue that was litigated in the election last fall. And as we approach tax day in a few days in this country, it is just foreign to most people to think that we're going to address our problems by raising taxes on the very people we expect to jump back into the game to create jobs, and those are our small business people.
In the Pledge to America, we laid out that we'd be very bold in our budget. The president put his out, Republicans put theirs out, and now the president thinks he has to do a sequel. The first budget was a bomb. As many of you know, being a sequel, none of them are better than the original, and the original failed. I think what we said when we did a path to prosperity, that we believed 2011 was the year that America made its great comeback, not the year that we faded into history. That's what this debate will be about. Being a former small business owner, we know that 70% of all jobs are created through small business. Taxing them never creates a new job.
Years ago, a prominent Republican senator once said, a billion here, a billion there, and pretty soon you're talking about real money. And over the last few weeks, we've been debating billions, and we are ready to start talking about trillions. The Ryan budget proposes to cut an estimated $6 trillion over 10 years. And it puts us on a path to actually pay off our national debt by 2050. As I think about our children and our grandchildren, What better future could we give them than a debt-free future? And as I think about small businesses, what better future could we give them than a debt-free future that would allow them to create jobs today? The Republicans are ready to go to work. We're interested in what the president's going to lay out in his budget today. We're hopeful that he will engage with us on a budget that cuts taxes, cuts spending, gets our fiscal house in order, and preserves that American dream for our children and our grandchildren.